Hello everyone, this is the CAT 2021 morning slot analysis. Now this is a preliminary analysis based on the feedback received from our faculty and the students. So let's see how the paper looked like. This is the sectional breakup. So as you can see, the total number of questions across the paper decreased by 10. So in CAT 2020, 76 questions were there. In this year, the questions were 66. Now, across the verbal ability and the reading comprehension, which was the first section, there were a total of 24 questions, out of which 5 were TETA. Similarly, in DILR, you can see 20 questions and 6 TETA questions. In quantitative ability, there were 22 questions, out of which 8 were TETA. So overall, we can see there was quite a high percentage of TETA questions, so 19 in a paper of 66 questions. Coming to the sectional difficulty, the verbal ability and reading comprehension was by far the toughest out of the three sections. So it could be considered overall moderate to tough, but it was on par with the last year exam. Coming to the DILR, that was moderate, and also the quant ability was easy to moderate, but both DILR and quantitative sections was relatively easier as compared to the last year exam. Overall, this year morning slot was at a moderate difficulty level as opposed to a moderate to tough, which was last year. Now coming to the individual sections, this is for the verbal ability and reading comprehension. So this was the roughly breakup. Out of a total of 24 questions, as we saw, 5 were TETA based. Now the TETA questions were mostly jumbled sentences. Now the difficulty level overall was on par with the last year exam, CAT 2020 morning slot. So reading comprehension, there were about 16 questions. So there were 4 passages of 4 questions each, and RCs were of moderate to tough difficulty level. Now the vocabulary usage in RC was medium to high frequency. So out of the 4 RCs, 3 were moderate to difficult and 1 was easy. Now out of these 16 questions, almost 14 were reasoning based or inferential in nature. Similarly, in verbal ability, the questions were spread across paragraph summary, jumbled sentences, and out of context statements, as you can see on the screen. Overall, 13 to 14 questions would be the good attempts. It is considered as a good attempt, which means 8 to 9 in RC and 3 to 4 in verbal ability questions. Coming to the DILR section, now overall, there were 2 sets of 4 questions each and 2 sets of 6 questions each. So a total of 20 questions, and this was of a difficulty level of moderate. Now out of a total of 20 questions, 6 were TETA based. Now this section was much easier than the last year's morning slot. Now in this case, one set was extremely easy, which was the pure DI. Now in DI, we had a bar graph based question, which was an easy one. And the other 2 sets were of average level. Now the mathematical reasoning also had a set involving cost price of mixtures. It was a 4 question set, and it was considered as the moderate difficulty level. And the remaining 2 sets were of 6 questions each. One was mapping based type arrangement question, and the other one was classification based. So people were to be classified in that puzzle based question. So overall, good attempts in this section would be to solve 2 to 3 sets. So overall, which corresponds to 10 to 11 questions out of a total of 20. Coming to the last section, which is quant. So out of a total of 22 questions, 8 were TETA. Now this was by far easier than the last year's morning slot. And overall, if we look at this section, this was majorly dominated by arithmetic. Overall, this was easy to moderate. As you can see, arithmetic, there were 10 questions, the majority, but most of the questions were easy in nature. The remaining questions were spread across algebra, geometry, and modern maths, as you can see on the screen. Overall, for this section, 13 to 14 questions could be considered as the good attempt. Overall, the morning slot of CAT 2021 was moderate, with a slightly tougher VA section and slightly easier DILR and QA sections compared to the last year. Also, no new question types were reported. So if you look at the overall performance, so 35 to 37 questions, if the student was able to solve with 80 to 85% accuracy, that can be considered as a good performance for this lot. All right, so now the slot 2 analysis would be uploaded shortly. Thank you very much.